So we're here today, obviously, to talk about Strike Force Tronto. Strike Force Tronto was formed in 2001, and it's an ongoing heightened awareness operation that we run in the summer period, particularly around danger periods. On the 1st of August 2019 was the first declaration, which happened up in the northern part of the state. At that stage, Tronto stood up and started collecting information around bushfires, whether it be suspicious or otherwise. Obviously, the disturbing fact, since the 1st of August to now, 54 individuals have had action taken against them in 69 fire-related incidents, which is concerning. Those offences they range from a $2,200 fine for lighting an open fire right up to offences relating to lighting fires which may endanger life or property, which carries 21 years. A number of individuals have been charged in relation to this operation. So today we have specialist investigators in the arson unit. There's 19 of them that are trained in wildfire. We also have run training for 40 other investigators this year in wildfire training. And the 19 individuals attached to State Crime's arson unit are supporting over 1,500 investigators across New South Wales. In the current period, we've assisted 4 police area commands and 12 police districts across the state, which sit in probably at the forefront of about 60 fires that are still rolling. So lastly, before I take questions, obviously there are worsening conditions ahead. We expect significant conditions over the next week's period. And obviously the Strike Force Tronto team obviously will raise their position across the state, and we will act on and provide advice to police area commands in support to the very dedicated 3,000 volunteers that are fighting the fires. Questions?
How many fires from this fire season are currently under investigation?
The cause of the fires, so at the moment there's 60 fires. There's a number of fires where there are suspicious circumstances, but it is a tedious process that we've got to work through with investigators to determine the cause. And obviously there have been 6 deaths, you know, during this danger period, which those will be investigated on behalf of the New South Wales coroner. What we're urging the public to do over the next week is be the eyes and ears of the New South Wales Police. We've reacted to numerous pieces of information, and those at times over the last week have resulted in the arrests of individuals who had an intention or did light a fire in a dangerous bushfire period.
Thank you. 54 people facing legal action, how many of those are children?
I can't give you the exact figure. Obviously, the police media unit will provide a run sheet later on, but what is disturbing is a number of those are young people. And there have been people that have been dealt with over the last week in terms of caution because of their age. The behaviours are ranging, you know, in terms of what we've seen over the last week, from, you know, stupid, reckless behaviour right up to a deliberate intent to light a fire.
Have any children been dealt with anything other than a caution at this stage?
That I can't tell you.
Why are they dealt with cautions instead?
Look, there's processes specific around juveniles, and there's specific legislation we work with. Obviously, as I said, there's a big difference between reckless, stupid behaviour up to an intentional act. The law allows for an incremental system, and we follow that. At this stage, I can't give you an indication of how many, if any, have been charged.
Have you seen an increase in the number of children lighting fires?
I think it's disturbing that 54 individuals had to have action taken against them. Now, whether that's a stupid act of lighting, you know, burning refuse in a banned period, the problem with the behaviour is, in a requisite danger period, you know, the air's loaded, the fuel load's high, and the likelihood that that fire will get away is a probability. There's really no difference between reckless and a deliberate act at this stage. We need the help of the public through this period. We know the public assisted us in the arrests of individuals. We do, out of the Strike Force Tronto strategy package, we do look at predictive and analytics, of which it's allowed us to target some individuals.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.